so sweet.
Bow. What's up, everybody? It's me, Craig X, and it's 420, so light 'em if you got 'em, just like I'm doing. We're kicking off another episode, episode 80, actually.
What?
Yeah, 80 episodes I've done now of Expert Joints Live, and, well, the Expert Live as well. Whatever. Still, 80 weeks in a row I've done this shit. Crazy. And this is going to be one of the coolest shows of the bunch, for sure. And with me, pulled out from under the seed desk, under the TV desk, under the weed desk, from under the influence, from Temple of Calyx, from Pot TV, from a wrecked beach, from a second beach, a third beach.
Third beach.
Somewhere in a shell, like a lobster. Hermit Crab himself, Weed Alpedia, the one and only Class in Session 666, Al the Alchemist.
What's happening, people?
Me and him doing it one more again, because it is been, and it still will be for another week. Temple month. Smoking temple products, lots and lots of them through. I'm smoking the controversial Hindu Master.
Woo!
Mm-hmm.
Interesting, eh?
Mm-hmm. That is quite interesting. It's, yes, that's another conversation for somebody else, but that's funny how shit works, that's all I'm going to say. Thanks for tuning in. Last week we had Matthew from Neo Canada, Derek and Big Chris from Thompson Caribou, Opus 420, and Sparkles over here jumped in on it. We smoked a bunch of weed, it was a lot of fun. Check the replay after this show.
That was a fun show, man. It really was.
Yeah, man. Thank you for holding it down. There were some people in the chat who were like, weren't sure about the level of stuff that this Neocana bit was on, and I didn't have the skills to really.
As this industry moves towards legitimacy, we're gonna, you know, there's always gonna be a certain level of resistance, and, you know, that's just natural.
Well, I mean, you know, it's just a learning curve to everything, right? And luckily, we had you to be able to ask some questions that. Shit, even I wouldn't have really been thinking about to ask. So he's more than just a pretty face, ladies and gentlemen. Speaking of pretty faces, check this face. Bam! Right here. Bam. Yeah.
Hey, Craig, how's it going? Hey, Al. What's happening, brother?
That's right.
Here.
Check it out, guys. That's Remo in the Remo cam. We're going to talk to him in just one couple of seconds. Of course, everybody knows Remo, man. Remo Nutrients or the lick. Award-winning, just uber grower, uber famous YouTube guy. Can't fucking wait to chop it up with this dude. Also, Tim's Tales, we got another episode of Saltwater Sessions with the one and only Saltwater Cowboy, Tim McBride. He'll be in. So we've got this show called Urban Legends. We've got the urban grower. We've got the legendary pot smuggler. We got Weed Alpedia. We got me. We figure that there's at least 100 to
140, I thought.
Yeah, 125 to 140 years of weed experience between the four of us.
Holy.
On this show. Involved in this show today. Yeah. So, Urban Legends is a great name.
I can feel the gray hairs grow in. Just wow.
Going to be a good one, man. And yes, so we've got Remo here. And we're going to have Tim on in a minute. Al's here. It's going to be a good one. We've got a lot of people in the chat room. Peter S. B. Dam, Chilling Like a Villain, John Farrell, Buzz TX, Christopher Reese, Wild Dragon, Tice Anderson, Archer 420. Of course, we've got the chat room over on Facebook rocking today as well, too. Brenda, Joe STG, what's up, squad? Dylan Bellinger, we got lots of people in the place to be. Can't wait to have this episode go down. So it's Temple Month, and of course, we've been smoking lots of temple flowers. I already kind of am smoking one right now, and it's one that we saw last week.
I gotta say, this zombie kush is really fucking good.
But yeah, so here's where we would normally go, where I roll up a joint of the temple folks, and then I go and I say, okay, and on with the show. But, well, I just want to get on with the show. I'll go this way for a minute, and I'll explain all this
double
in a minute.
Fister.
Right? So, yes, normally, I would roll up a joint of some temple, and then I would say, okay, great. And then I would introduce my guest, Remo. But instead, Remo's got great weed, and we're just going to roll up with him. Plus, he's also got somewhere to be shortly after this, so we're just going to speed this up by a couple minutes and help my man out. Right. Jumping right to it, ladies and gentlemen. Viewed more than 33 million times on YouTube alone as the urban grower, Remo has helped thousands of people learn the skills necessary to produce a world-class product. His expertise covers all levels of growing and has landed him at least 23 awards worldwide. Remo brings his vast experience to Remo Nutrients, creating 8 products that offer a complete system of vitamins, minerals, and extracts to your plant's needs to achieve their maximum growth potential. Ladies and gentlemen, one of the best growers on the planet, someone I've been trying to get on the show for a better part of a year. Please finally welcome the urban grower himself. It's Remo.
All hey, right. Hey, Craig. Thanks for having me.
Man, happy to have you, brother. But I do feel that I should probably do this for the rest of the show.
All right.
Just to, oh,
yeah. Al, you didn't get the memo?
No.
Do we got a pair of sunglasses for Al?
I don't read memos.
I would have brought extra ones if Al needed. Oh, we're finding your glasses here.
We have guests.
Oh, wait.
Here we go.
There's guest shades.
Jan's got some glasses for you.
Holy shit.
The backup glasses.
Oh, man, these are officials, too.
They are the official glasses.
Wow. You got official glasses?
Yeah, those are them.
Oh, wow.
I never knew that.
No, I don't feel nearly as cool now. Oh, well.
Oh, look at
the side. Do the side profile.
Yeah, I gotta switch that over to the bigger cam so we can see that a little bit better. Give him a little shot
the
there.
The colors there.
There you go. My man, Remo official sunglasses. You can get those only from Remo.
And you know
not
what's crazy about
the
sunglasses?
And eBay. And Amazon.
I feel twice as cool as I did before.
Right?
Just like that. Bam.
Instantly.
Just like that.
Just instantly. And I feel like I need to point at people. Yeah. Just a lot of people
that'll,
pointing.
That'll happen.
Let's do it. Let's
yeah,
do it.
Let's point. There you go. I got replacements right here.
There you go. Stand-ins.
Stunt double.
Well, it was nice knowing you, Remo. You've been usurped. No. The dude is crazy, man. Honestly, one of the legends in the game and one of my inspirations when I started my whole journey. So thank you for doing what you're doing. Kind of helps us do what we do, man.
No problem. You're welcome.
And hard guy to pin down, man. I've been chasing you for a year. 11 trips in 12 months in 2016. Plus, you got Spanibus in Jamaica literally coming in a few weeks, don't you?
Yeah, March is going to be busy. I got 3 trips, 1 month. We're also doing the lift in Edmonton. Yeah, I went from taking 2 months off and not traveling to 3 in 1 month. Just
crazy.
Yeah.
Well, let's get right into the meat and potatoes, man. You're obviously going to be going to showing off at the trade shows. Of course, you're you and you're a celebrity and you're famous. You're going to shoot your great videos. But the bread and butter, let's get right to it. Remo Nutrients, man. Tell them, run down the product line, what you've got, and then tell us, of course, what makes them so damn good.
Well, what I've done is made a modern nutrient line. Most of my competitors had come up with their products 25, 30 years ago, and they didn't really do anything to improve them except for expand them. So you have these, you know, complicated lines that take, you know, 15, 20 bottles that you have to mix together. So what we did is we made a lot more streamlined. We condensed it and put things that could live together in the same bottle. So we came up with a two-part program with 4 additives, and that's all you need for flour, and you can have crazy results. Like, well, I'm going to show you some of the buds here.
Yeah, man, you've been known to grow some shit, man. Yeah, and of course, Al, of course. Well, what do you think of Newman product?
I've seen so many growers locally and online really step up their game by switching to your line. There's no way around it.
Well, you know what? If you're looking for terpene production, we have a lot of blackstrap molasses in there. It's an old school way to bring terpenes out, but we also use 3 amino acids, which really brings it out. So that's the difference. You can grow weed, or you can grow great weed, and that's what you can grow with Remo Nutrients.
And of course, you get those products in 11 countries around the world, 300 different stores. That's amazing.
11 countries now?
Yeah, we're spreading, man. Right? We're everywhere. Yeah.
And the website just spread all over the screen for a second, man. You can check out the dope-ass RemoNutrients.com. They got all the information about there, kind of how you got going, all the different products. I mean, let me see if I can click on here and activate this. Yeah, you can. You got, as you say, a number of different products available in your various different formulations, man. I'm going to cycle through a few of these, let people see them for a second. But you've really got the whole line covered. People, one-stop shop with Remo Nutrients?
Well, you know what? If you're looking for a complete nutrient system to grow great weed, this is it. And if you compare us to the competitors, instead of doing a lot of expensive advertising, these guys, you've seen what the competitors do. They have full page ads in these magazines. They're really expensive. And
show up to a trade show with an army tank, and
stuff like that.
Circus of
and then you know who pays for that is consumers. So if you look at my product compared to my competitors, we're substantially cheaper, like probably 40% of GH. So you're going to save some money. You're going to grow some better weed. And the only way I market my product is
importantly,
YouTube.
Better weed.
That's it. So it doesn't cost the consumer anything. I just make my YouTube videos. We show the buds that I grow, and that seems to be enough.
Well, it speaks for itself, man. I mean, that's what, let's face it, in this day and age, being an influencer in marketing terms is what you are, and when people can go on and legitimately see giant fucking buds the size of their head, and you win trophy after trophy after trophy, it speaks for itself, and people want to replicate that, man. I mean, I know you brought some, again, we're supposed to be smoking Temple products. You smoke Temple products all the time.
I smoke it all the time. I'm more than happy to smoke some
weed. Oh, no, you know what? Al's a real stoner. He wants to smoke all the weed.
All the weed. Yeah, right. I smoke all that shit before.
I like ugly, raggy, seedy weed. I like compressed brick weed. I like all weed.
Well,
I really do.
Every time I see Al, though, he's always got, oh, here's another jar. And then I got this. And I got that.
I'm low on jars because I haven't grown in a year. It's my 25th anniversary of growing weed, so I decided I would take pretty much the year off.
Oh, good for you.
And focus on other things that...
How's that going?
It's really good. I was able to do a whole lot of other things that I wasn't able to do while I was growing.
You know what? It takes a lot of time. People don't realize how big of a commitment it is to grow a crop. Because it's like having a child. It's not like you can have a weekend off and go back Monday and there it is.
It's like having 100 or 200 children.
Yeah. It's exactly like having 200 children if you have a license that thing.
Yeah, of course. Consult your medical professional. So today, I know that you did bring out some of your award winners, man. You brought the zombie and the Gorilla Glue, did you not?
I brought them both. I got them in jars right here. Which one do you want to look at first? I see you got a microscope.
I do. I have Stoner the bud cam. Microscope. I have the bud cam in here. Brought to you today. Remo, pass me the Gorilla Glue. Let's get started with that one.
This was actually Bud of the Week. We shot a video. And... actually, I think tomorrow's video is a Gorilla Glue extract.
Oh, nice. Ooh. Well, I'm going to take a chunk of this Gorilla Glue here. I'm going to go ahead and throw it in the old handy-dandy bud cam.
Another formulation. You guys take a dab for a second.
But I've changed the way hash is.
Oh. It's not rosin.
God. Hang on. Is that in focus or am I just driven? Oh, there we go. Oh my God. No, it's just that frosty. Ladies and gentlemen.
It is that frosty.
Oh my Lord have mercy.
You know, when we trim this one, we get the most hash that we've ever seen. But it's a different weed. Like, if you're going to try to win a cup with this one, it's got a very delicate terpene, and it dissipates very quickly.
Yeah, it's not loud at all.
Like, at the beginning, it's there. And then a few weeks later, it starts to fade off pretty quick.
I think it's high in, what is it, humulin? I think it's humulin.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, it's awesome smoke. I can see why it's
you know what happens when you suck on humulene? Right, you start like this. brought to you by Remo Nutrients. These medicinals in the camera right here, that is the Gorilla Glue. For those who have been sort of half paying attention, you can check out me smoking multiple joints at the same time, but I'm not really passing.
Spin one of those Gorilla Glues up?
Yes, I'm going to spin one of those up. I'm fighting a little bit of the sniffles today. I don't know if I'm having an allergy thing or if it's a cold. I don't have all the symptoms of a cold, so I'm on the... I got a new air purifier, and something's changing me in the middle of the night. I woke up all weird. But on the air of, on the airing of caution, I'm not sharing joints, touching them. So in the bud cam is that. So you know what?
Yeah.
I'm going to roll that up. That is a good idea, Remo. I'm going to roll the Gorilla Glue, but you know what's an even better idea?
What's that?
Watching this video about the Gorilla Glue that you did from Marijuana Monday.
Sounds good.
Okay, let's do that then. So I'm gonna click that, click this, and go kaboom. Y'all watch this.
It's Monday, and it's time for Marijuana Money's Ring Review. And today we're gonna review the Gorilla Glue number 4. This is one of my new favorite strains, and we're gonna see why. Let's grab some of these buds and go outside and take a close look. Let's go. I really like growing the Gorilla Glue number 4. It produces the most finger hash out of any of the strains I currently grow. It's just amazing weed. Let's go inside and roll some up. Okay, it's time to roll up a joint. Let's throw some in our grinder. I'm telling you, this is beautiful weed, but it's got a very subtle terpene in it. Okay, let's crunch some of the stuff up, and then we'll give it the sniff test. Oh, it's ground up. Oh, smelling this stuff, it smells great. It's kind of got a sour smell with a mixture of lemon and pine. Kind of interesting. But I noticed one thing, when the stuff is fresh, it's got that smell real strong. It could win you cups. But it's when it sits around for a little while, this terpene dissipates very quickly. Here, you want to give it a sniff?
Yeah.
So this is supposed to be a moderate producer.
I don't know.
I think it worked pretty good, produced pretty well for me. It seemed to produce better with the LED lights, which was really weird. I've never seen a strain do that. It really grooved on those LED lights. And apparently the suggested medical use for this strain is menstrual cramps.
How's it working?
I don't know, we'll find out after this joint. If I don't have any menstrual cramps, I guess it worked. I don't need menstrual cramps now though. There's our joint. What do you think?
It's a bat.
Rock and roll, here we go.
And we're back. Hey, here's Remo's face, and there's us. So that was the Gorilla Glue number 4 review from Mushroom on a Monday. If you want to see, well, that's part of it. If you want to see the rest of it, make sure you go ahead and check out Remo's YouTube page. Look at that right there. 33 million views. That's pretty impressive, homeboy. God damn.
A lot of those were me.
Mostly him and his mom. His mom just, toss my baby. Oh, he's just so good.
Remo's got it going on a leash.
What actually he did is he got some guys on Craigslist. He paid them $3 an hour and a big fat of weed, bag of weed, and just said, listen, just go kidding refresh. Oh, yeah. And refresh.
I've heard of those things.
Yeah, right. Exactly.
I'd rather spend that money on weed.
Yeah. Ain't gonna lie. So as mentioned, you actually mentioned in this video that was the Gorilla Glue that you saw in the HPS versus LED side by side comparison. You've been running a whole series of those for like the last 2 months, really, right?
Yeah, I grew a crop, and what I did is I took 3 different strains. I had 6 LED lights from Spectrum King. They're SK600s.
Those are the round?
No, they're square.
Oh, okay.
And they're got no fans in it, no moving parts. And I put it head-to-head up against 1,000-watt HPS.
And?
Well, these are my results. I used 3 different strains, and I'm glad I used 3 different strains because I learned something doing this. The light reacts differently with different strains.
Yep.
For example, with the Gorilla Glue, it actually grew bigger buds than the HPS with the LED light, and you had to see it to believe it. And then, I took the plants, put them side by side, and actually, we've already harvested, and I can tell you this is something before my channel's gonna learn this.
Well, wait, save it, because I'm gonna show them the video. Wait till after the video to get the results from the way out.
Welcome back to our LED versus HPS light comparison.
Sorry,
we took an SK600 LED light from Spectrum King and we put it up against a 1,000-watt HPS light that's seen over there. And like to show you this first off, we used 3 different strains. We used MK Ultra, we used the Gorilla Glue, and we used one of my favorites, the Zombie Kush from Ripper Seed. I tried to put all the plants an even distance from the light, as you can see here. And actually with these MKs, because they don't grow as much, we had to put milk crates under them, as you can see, to elevate them up towards the light. We learned something doing this comparison. It appears that different plants, different strains, react differently to the light. It appears that this plant here, the Gorilla Glue number 4, really loves the light. And we're gonna take this plant right here, because it's on the outside row and it's not getting any sidewatch of HPS, and we're gonna compare it to this one over here. Come with me. You got this Gorilla Glue right on the end. What's interesting about this Gorilla Glue is that it's actually straddled between 2 1,000-watt lamps. And the bud size, just visually inspecting it right now, does not look the same size. It looks like it's actually smaller. But it looks like it's going to be super kick-ass weed. Well, let's move these plants out of the way and put the 2 plants side by side so we can do a visual inspection on both. We've got the plants both in place, and it's time for the epic battle right here, right now. In this corner we have the HPS plant. We wheeled it in all the way from the far end of the room, and there she is right there. And on this side, we have the LED. Wow. Now let's look at the HPS first. Looks really nice. Nice size buds. Now let's look at the LED. Visually looking at this, it looks like there's a little more foxtailing up top. You see that? And it looks like her bud size are approximately the same. Now let's just feel the buds for density. That's nice and tight. Also nice and tight. Oh, smells great. Wow. The only way to truly tell is to chop them down and to weigh them. Let's get that camera close in there so we can visually inspect that HPS plant. Let's give her. Now it's time for the LED plant right here. And just looking at this plant, it looks a little bit happier. As you can see on the top, like I mentioned earlier, seems to be foxtailing a little bit more, but I think that this light is a lot more intense. Let's get the camera close in so you folks at home can see these awesome buds. The biggest bud in the room award goes to the Gorilla Zoo number 4 right there. Check that bud out. Got something right here to compare it to. That is a big bud. Nice job, Gorilla Glue.
Yep, and that was Remo
with
the Gorilla Glue. That was, well, part of it. That was just the Gorilla Glue. There was the Zombie Kush and the MKU that go on in the rest of that. Again, check that review on the YouTube page. The Urban Remo YouTube page. Go to youtube.com/user/UrbanRemo.
That's right.
My man. That's the one there. Check out all these super cool videos. That was actually like this one right here or something. Super dope page, man. So what was I going to say? Next on this. That's pretty interesting. Like you say, so some strains are reacting better to LED than HBS. And you said that the Gorilla Glue, when you chopped it up, the big live results, what is it?
Well, I can't share numbers, but I can tell you this. It outperformed, the LED outperformed HPS with the Gorilla Glue.
By a percentage, maybe? Or?
If I had to put a percentage on that, we're talking maybe 15, 20% maybe at the most.
Really?
Yeah. It was impressive.
20%
is
a lot.
Yeah. So however, okay, when it came to the Zombie, about the same.
Yeah.
But then it looked like when the MK Ultra, the HPS did better. So I think what can be learned here is that if you're going to grow with LED, try different plants and go with the one that works best with the light. Because you know, all these manufacturers said these lights work with all the plants, but they don't. And there's plants that do better and plants that don't do as good. What I think it is the MK Ultra doesn't like the intense light, where the Gorilla Glue loved it and actually grew bigger buds because of it. So it's, you know, it's just like people. Not all people are the same, right? Mm-hmm. They're different people, do different things.
You know, thing now, would you say with the LEDs, like...
I think they're worth getting.
On average, gram per watt.
It's totally possible to get a gram per watt.
Yeah?
Yeah, easy. Easily.
Really,
Yeah.
That's impressive.
Yeah. That's what that technology is. Look at the beginning. It was like Spider-Man light. And you got some nice buds on top and nothing down below.
And really no trichome production and not much.
They sucked. Yeah. But now it's actually there. And if you look at the video, because we got the camera guy there to stick the camera right in there and get the lens dirty. And yeah, it's no shit. When you look at both on the comparison, they're both deadly.
Price point for the technology? Comparison?
It's a little expensive. It's cost prohibitive. They're $2,000 a light currently.
Versus what for 1,000 watt?
Well, you can buy 1,000 watt for maybe $230, $250.
Right.
And then maybe another $50 for the bulb. So it's a lot cheaper to do the HPS.
Yeah.
However, it's all you're paying when you buy an LED light. You're paying a lot front end because you're gonna save a lot on the bulb changes because the product life is 11 years.
Yeah.
So for 11 years, you're not changing any bulbs. Where HPS light every 6 months or a year, most growers will swap them out.
Yeah.
So you're paying out all the time. Then there's the power savings.
Yeah.
So you know versus a thousand.
Your footprint is
well, and your temperature in the room obviously would be lower then. So then you've got to then obviously work not as hard to have to cool the room as well too. So even more power savings, the spin-off factor with it.
You know what'll eventually happen, just like any product, because this is good technology. When the price comes down, when it starts to be more mass-produced, the price will come down, and it'll be more affordable, and more and more people will use it. But until that point comes, I think it's just going to keep getting better and better. But it's actually getting to the point where you can grow kick-ass weed with LED. And I think
Gorilla Glue's no joke.
People will start buying them. After you see the video, they're going to go, shit, I can buy a couple of those, set them up, you know, not a lot of heat. Easy to use, not swapping bulbs.
You put a 600 in a 4x4 tent, and that's banging.
Oh, you kick ass.
Oh, that's as warm as it needs to be, man.
Yeah, and that's.
But I embrace new technology. If there's new products that are good,
Sure.
Let's use them, right?
Right. Well, and what I think is really cool is I've known people who've used LEDs, and I think part of it is the technology is certainly getting better. But it's a thing that I think you pointed out that I'm not even sure if anybody or how many other people have tested and done the side-by-sides really to figure that out. But how do they actually work side-by-side, same place, same time? And to see the differences between different strains, I mean, have the manufacturers seen those, duplicate anybody else? Have you heard anybody else who've experienced
those? I called the manufacturer up and I said, hey, I did a test and these are my results. Kick ass with this one plant, about the same with this other. The other plant didn't like it, and I asked them straight up, has anybody ever reported that different strains do better with the LED light? And they said no. So,
interesting.
You know, well, we're learning all the time.
Because it works that way indoors too.
Yeah.
I mean, or with HPS as well, as I should say.
Some plants just respond better.
I should mention this, that the MK Ultra, when we get that one too close to the HPS bulb, it does taco as well too. So I think it's just the plant doesn't like the super intense light.
Some are just different, right? Some maybe you're used to a little more cloudy climates if you want to, right?
So, yeah. Well, it's a heavy indica. It's just does not like that light.
You know what else is a fairly heavy one? That zombie cushy yours.
You know what? It's not an indica. It's more a sativa.
Still, it's pretty stony, man. It'll leave you like this.
We should take a look at it.
Here's I think we should. Let's get one of those in the bud cam. Boom, check that out. Blah! Right. Slap that in the bud cam.
Give it the microscope.
That's something. Right. Yeah, it's so tasty.
Oh, good God.
So amnesia to lavender.
And back cross with Bubba Kush, but the European one.
To the U.S. Bubba. Euro Bubba. Which is
it's
spirit.
Obnoxious.
It's what do you want? The more spear-like one.
Brought to you by Remo Nutrients. Check out RemoNutrients.com and at the Urban Grower across social media. Of course, if you're the age of 19 and choose to do so. This is the zombie good.
And that's from Ripper Seeds. I got these seeds in Barcelona at Spanibus.
Those guys are awesome, guys.
Oh, yeah. What's funny thing is that I went back and talked to them and said, hey, you know, thanks for the seeds. They're doing great. You know, I love the smoke. I've got these awesome plants, probably one of my favorite plants. And they go, oh, that's last year's weed. They gave me some more seeds. And they said, this is called Badass. So I'm now growing that one right now. And that's... Nice. Gonna be the next
cycle. Last year's right.
This stuff's way better. That's what they told me.
Chucking out your Nikes and shit.
Because the zombies kick ass.
Yeah.
Oh man, well I'm rolling this up right now. I'm smoking the Gorilla Glue as it is right now. Everybody's smoking a wild variety of everything. But that's really cool. You say you want a span of this. It kind of segues a little bit, man, to some of the events that you've been to and places you've gone to, that all your videos and the 33 million views and all the awards you've won and all this shit. I mean, that's partly because you go and do all this stuff, yet also because you have all this success, you go and do that as well now too, right? It's a strange, you're part exhibitor, part media. It's a neat position to be in, right?
I'm multitasking. I wear many hats.
One man gang. And I don't want to say wealthy info. I mean, people, that's what I think people appreciate the most out of you. We've had a bunch of questions in the chat. How well does your product ship in lower temperatures?
Well, it doesn't. What we have to do is, if we're shipping it to somewhere that's freezing, we have to have climate control or frost protection.
Nice.
Because it shouldn't freeze. Right. But, you know, on the other end of the spectrum, it shouldn't boil either. You shouldn't get that really, really hot. So,
right. So there you
climate control or heated service is probably a good idea.
Nice. Or air or cooled in the summer, air conditioned in the summer.
Exactly.
See, my man thinks everything. World's biggest joint video is your biggest video on your page. 2 million views on that one. It is no joke. The as many views as I think I have on my entire page. That's pretty significant, man. What's been your sort of favorite ones to do? What videos does Remo enjoy doing the most? You do so many of them. You cover so much. Like every day, you're putting out something new.
Yeah, actually, my two favorites right now are Marijuana Monday and Hash Wednesday, the Hash Dice game.
Hash dice.
You roll a dice and you smoke some hash. It's fucking awesome.
Right?
That's a great game.
I want to come be on that show.
That sounds like
you need to be on that show.
Sounds like
we'll do a handout.
Right?
You need to come out and we'll get you on that show.
Make it happen.
And you can win a 70s prize. You know, some Tab Cola or Rice-A-Roni.
I was just going to say, I saw somebody.
Coffee made. I don't know.
I was jealous of that dude who got the Rice-A-Roni. Of course, you know. Like it's an incredible tool and a way to put yourself out there, like you said, to sell your products, but get your voice out there. Shit, man. And of course, all the tips and advice you've been giving people has been amazing, but so has all the trophies you've won. Like, yeah. That's a lot. You've done pretty well, man. As I said at the event last couple weeks ago, it's not a cup until you hand Remo a trophy. which I did at the Karma Cup too, and on and on. You win all the time, man. I mean, that's got to feel pretty good to see your hard work paying off.
Yeah, well, you know what? I think it proves to the customers that our nutrients really work. I don't see the owner of General Hydroponics growing weed, showing his buds on YouTube, entering competitions and winning shit. I just don't see it.
That shit's nasty too. It leaves a funny taste in every weed that it grows. I can smell it from 100 miles away, and I don't smoke it.
Well, you know what? I used General Hydroponics, you know, at the beginning, and I used it for years. I probably, you know, made those guys a lot of money. You know, I've grown past that.
Yeah, now it's time for RemoNutrients.com. Check them out. Get it and start over there. And of course, speaking of wins, we had the big win. Quick little trophy presentation again. Man, I like handing you trophies, Remo.
And we're going up.
So we'll do this. Come back.
I got 15 beautiful trophies behind me here to hand out. 5 different categories. 3rd, 2nd, and 1st. So I guess there ain't nothing to it but to do it. I got 2 lovely assistants gonna help me out. Make some noise for Cypher and Celeste. Easy butt gal, Cypher rapping, doing it! Is definitely gonna make it happen. Alright, I'm gonna start down here first. Down this end, work our way down to the DJ, work our way to the middle of the table. Who likes to get high in the daytime? Who likes to get high in the nighttime? Who likes to get high all the time? Okay, coming in at number 1 in Sativa with the big trophy again. There's a dab ring, just put a little banger in there, you can go. Wow, isn't that fancy? Excuse me. I missed rehearsal. The Zombie Kush! Number entry D. Yeah. The Urban Grower, Remo! Now I know Remo's in the house, he was downstairs. Shouts to Urban Grower, man. It's not a contest if Remo doesn't win an award, let's face it. There he is! Remo! Come get your trophy, son! Yeah, move it this way. Okay. Yes, man. They're coming soon. I gotta do this. Sorry, this is the whole cup. Remo's here. What's up, Remo?
Okay.
How are you, brother?
I'm doing great. How you doing?
Great, man. Good to see you back up on here. It's been about 3-4 months since I handed you a trophy, man. It was getting lonely.
Awesome. This is way too cool.
Tell us a little bit about what was this one. This is the Zombie Kush, man.
Lavender crossed with Amnesia, and then back crossed with Bubba Kush with the European Bubba Kush.
Holy fucking Remo, right? Make some noise for the Urban Grower! One of the absolute best at doing it in the game, alright? Seriously, one of the best growers in Canada, man. Prolific time and time. Get you some Remo nutrients, baby. I'm sure I will see you again at the next cup, brother. Thank you, Urban. Give him 1 plug. How do they find you on social?
Urban Grower or Urban Remo on YouTube.
Yeah. All right, my dude. I love that guy, man. He chose some good fucking memes. And coincidentally, that was my pick as well for first.
Bro, that was a dope event. You killed it.
Thanks.
It's a lot of fun, man. I gotta ask you the favorite 4 questions, and I know you gotta get out of here, but before we go, you know, I've been known to have some breaking news, some premieres, some exclusives. We've dropped some fucking knowledge. We're gonna have another one, an exclusive later on in the update here, but I hate to do it to you, Remo. I like you. You're a great guy, but I think I have to give away your secret to how you're actually so successful here. I've cracked the code.
Okay.
There's a little unknown...
The Da Vinci code.
Yeah, right? I'm going to have to expose your secret to the world. Ladies and gentlemen, you want to know why he's so successful and how he's won so many cups and he wins time after time? He has a master strategy technique, and you've never seen it before. Well, you're going to see it here. It's crazy. The breaking news, why Remo is so good, video... footage to prove it. Watch this. This is crazy.
I've got to see this.
This is tough, man. Sorry, Remo. I hate to out you, brother, but I have to
do
it.
That's okay. I don't mind. Make it look bad.
Wait, hold it. There's a lot of poo. I like it.
And that, ladies and gentlemen, is the secret to Remo's success.
All right. I thought it was these joints, but
no, that's how he does, man. It is no, it's a pretty funny cartoon, man. That's awesome, bro. I mean, and what's the story with that? You said it's just somebody who makes them and
Actually, the guy that makes them, he's really talented, really brilliant guy. His name's Rob Moore, but I've talked to him on the phone. I've never met him face to face, but he makes all the cartoons just by watching the channel, and he sees, you know, the different people on the channel, and he takes those people and puts them in cartoon. It's hilarious. Mike over there is in cartoon.
Yeah, he is.
We got Bubble Man, JB.
I've seen a bunch of different people. There's a few of them again.
Actually, camera guys made it.
That's right.
They put him in, you know, we have that thing called Twin Cam.
Yeah, the Twin Cam.
He appears in the corner.
100%.
Well, in the cartoon, he appears in the corner.
Singing at one point. I saw that.
Oh, you saw that one?
Yeah, that's a smoking good likeness, man. He's actually a little bit more handsome than you are, though. I mean, I'm kidding.
A lot of people think our cameraman is really James Hetfield.
It really is, man. He takes time off from Metallica to do this with us. See, what it is, he was so frustrated with his performance at the Grammys with the microphones and shit. He said, fuck it, I'm going to Pot TV and getting high. Thanks, James. Yeah. Appreciate you coming through. Okay, we've got like literally about 5 minutes before Remo's got to get out of here, man. Gotta ask you, and then I can let you go. The same questions everybody asked. Literally, you're one of the biggest names in marijuana. Cannabis is your whole fucking world at this point.
Thanks.
It all had to start somewhere. So asking you the favorite four questions that I ask everyone. Question number one.
Okay.
How and when did you get into weed?
Oh, as a young child.
Yeah?
In school. I think the first time I smoked weed, I really didn't get high on it. One of my friends had a joint, and there was like 10 of us, and we all smoked this pinner joint, and it was like, do you get high? I don't know, I don't feel anything. Do you get high? And then we didn't get high off that. And but the first time I really, really got high was when I was in grade 8. And a friend of mine has this red hash. It was red Lebanese. Yeah. And we went to his place, and we smoked a couple bowls, and that did it.
That was the one.
And that changed everything. And I've always been a connoisseur of cannabis, but then I had a car accident. And I was taking all these drugs. And I remember going to the doctor and going, man, I'm taking all these weird drugs. And he goes, what, you got anything else? He goes, yeah, here. He gave me the strip. I remember it was a strip with all these pills in it. And he goes, you just take one of these and you put them under your tongue. And I go, what is it? And he goes, it's Ativan. And I go, what's that? And it's an antidepressant, so you're not as depressed about taking all these pills. And I thought, well, this is bullshit. So I went home,
wow.
I took them.
That's an interesting angle.
And I came back and I said, you got anything else? And he goes, didn't you ever smoke weed when you were young? There's this thing called medical marijuana. Maybe just try smoke a few joints. And I was like, well, I totally like smoking weed. But I never realized it was medicine. And actually, that's when I realized it was really medicine. And I realized I needed it. But the funny thing is when I went back to the same doctor later on to get a signature for a license, he didn't want anything to do with it.
You know? I recommend
it. But I was
like,
dude, you told me it was medicine, which it really was. And actually, because of the cannabis, because I was in a lot of painkillers, I managed to wean myself off all those painkillers. And I currently don't take pills at all. All I do is smoke cannabis for my medicinal needs. And,
so,
you know, it's actually liberating. Because cannabis gives you your life back.
It really does.
So then question two. So your preferred method of consumption, if you will. Do you like joints, bong? Yeah, joints.
Joints. All the way.
All the way. See?
You know, don't get me
expert
wrong.
Expert joints.
Don't get me wrong. I don't mind doing a dab. I don't mind smoking hash or, you know, maybe some rosin. I appreciate all forms of cannabis.
Sure.
But really, first thing I do in the morning is smoke a joint.
That's my man. That's what I'm talking about, Remo, right? Question number three. So how much do you smoke in a day?
Approximately an ounce.
Okay, there you go. That's pretty
I'd
heavy.
I'd say, well, these joints, if you look at them, they're about 2 grams, sometimes 2 grams plus. Here, check out the joint. Do you have a scale here?
Actually, it's the one thing I don't have.
Oh, okay.
Here, put it on the bigger can.
That's a 2 gram joint right there. And the reason I like to roll them like this, people say, well, why don't you use bigger paper? Actually, I don't want any more paper. I'm rolling them this big so it's less paper.
What's
the healthier joint?
Well, yeah. Then may I ask then, Remo, a question that we used to ask a lot of people, but I want to ask this one, and we'll go with question 3.5 this week then. What's your preferred brand of paper?
You're looking at it. smoking the Lux Black Package.
Yeah, he likes the smoking blacks.
Smoking.
We happen to be big fans of smoking here on this show. That's right.
Nice. No, they're real papers.
Legit.
I've had great
best papers in the world, man.
But eventually, you know what? I'm going to have to say it. I'll come up with my own papers. I just haven't switched that yet.
Yep.
Nice. That'll take lots of research and stuff. And a lot of, you know, R&D and
so tell you
many
what,
joints.
I've done a lot of the research and I've done some. We can have a conversation. We got something to talk about off air another time. Yes.
All right.
And then question number four. Out of all the weed that you've ever smoked, the last one to leave it, you can say it, drop the mic, and peace out. Out of all the weed that you've ever smoked, there has to think back of one that stands out over all the rest, is the most memorable bag that you ever had. And it's like, oh, I just wish there was that one bag again. So we call it the one that got away. What's the most memorable bag Remo ever smoked?
Skunk weed. Skunk number one from the 80s. It's just not around. I used to grow it. And it was too stinky.
Like roadkill.
It would get you busted. Yeah. You could grow one single plant and you'd smell that down the block and everybody would smell it.
That's the skunk I was talking about.
Actually, a lot of people grew that in the 80s. And I think the skunk number one is what started the growing revolution indoors.
100%.
Because up until that point, we're smoking outdoor weed or we're smoking brown brick weed from Mexico. And it was shit weed. Yeah. And I remember this is when I was in high school. You could have that or you could have this skunk weed for $40 a bag. And I was like, oh, give me that eighth of skunk weed for 40.
Yeah.
It's like kicks your ass when you smoke a joint. Yeah. And people started growing that shit inside.
Crazy electric green.
Oh, yeah. It was just fantastic. Man, but then everybody started growing it. It started stinking everywhere. And then they started busting people. I noticed in the 90s, a lot of people went to hash plants because they didn't smell as much.
Right.
And you can grow a nice crop.
Big, funky, chunky buds.
You don't stink out the block. Gets you really high. But, you know, if you look at the terp profile of that weed compared to that Sensi Skunk number one, there's no match.
No. That's it, man. There's no match for Remo the Urban Grower. Check him out on Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook. Also, RemoNutrients.com and Urban Remo on YouTube. Anything we missed? Plugs, shout-outs, things to watch for in 2017?
I think you got it covered.
Love it.
We're going to be rolling out tons of videos, usually 5-6 videos a week. So, Urban Remo on YouTube.
Ladies and gentlemen, absolute pleasure. One of the best interviews I've ever had. I've been looking for this, man. Remo, I would love if you could stay the whole show, but I know you got to get you and your entourage out of here, man. Go have fun at the show tonight.
Will do. Hey, thanks for having me, Craig. It's been a blast.
Appreciate it, man. Thank you so much.
Okay, brother. Thanks for the week.
Hey, we're going to get you on for Hash Dice.
I'll be in touch, man. We'll give you a shout for sure.
Awesome.
And when you go, let's just take that microphone off you here.
Oh, yeah. You can have your mic back.
Yeah, right?